Oh, hi, Billy.
Hi, Miss April. I was really excited to come here today.
Oh, good. Was there any particular reason?
Yeah, I heard something about there being presents.
Presents? No. Oh, you must be talking about our topic for today, the gifts of the Holy Spirit.
Oh.
The Holy Spirit was given to those who believed in Jesus on the day of what? Do you know?
Mother's Day?
No, the day of Pentecost. Have you ever heard of Pentecost, Billy?
Oh, yeah, I've heard of it.
Great. What do you know about it?
Okay, well, I don't know a whole big bunch, but I know there was far.
Far?
Yeah.
Far, like a long distance away?
No, Miss April.
Sorry, I don't know what you mean. Can you use far in a sentence?
Okay. On the day of Pentecost, there was the sound of rushing wind, and then there was far.
Okay, that didn't help. Do you know how to spell far?
Yes. F-I-R-E. Far.
Oh, fire! Yes! There were tongues of fire on everyone that was in the upper room when they were filled with the Holy Spirit.
That's what it meant, tongues of fire.
Well, that's very good, Billy. What else do you know about the day of Pentecost?
Let me think. Oh, yeah. Afterwards, they had a lot of power.
Oh, boy. I wish you had subtitles, Billy. Can you spell that word for me, too?
No, I don't know how to spell that one. It's too big.
Okay, can you describe it?
Okay. I really thought you'd have a bigger vocabulary, Miss April.
Well, I thought I did have a bigger vocabulary until you stopped by, Billy. What is par?
It's like special strength or ability.
Oh, power!
Right, that's what I said, par.
Power is on our scripture verse for today that's found in Acts 1:8. The last thing that Jesus told his followers before he was taken into heaven was that they would receive power after the Holy Spirit came upon them. And then they would have the courage to witness to people about him in Jerusalem, in all of Judea and Samaria, and to the end of the earth. The Holy Spirit gives us power to do things that we would normally be afraid to do or would be impossible for us to do. I didn't realize you were saying power. You know, Billy, I'm starting to notice that you have a very distinct accent.
Accent?
Yeah, sometimes the way someone pronounces words helps us figure out where they're from. Let me guess. Did you move here from the Ozarks?
Noah's Ark?
No, the Ozarks. It's a mountain range in Arkansas. Did you move here from Arkansas?
No, I'm from Paris.
Wow. I would have not have guessed that. Did you live anywhere else before that? Alabama, maybe?
Nope. Paris, Tennessee, born and raised. That is, until we moved here.
Well, I'm not from here originally either. Do you want to guess where I'm from?
Ouagadougou?
No, that's a good guess, but no. I'm not from a city in Africa.
Oh. I thought my teacher said it was in Michigan. I'm not very good at geometry.
I think you mean geography.
That's what I meant. Geology.
Geography.
Oh, I wish I was better at learning stuff, Miss April.
Yay, that reminds me of two of the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Did you know that the Holy Spirit can give us information that we haven't even learned?
What?
Two of the gifts we have available to us from the Holy Spirit are words of wisdom and words of knowledge.
Well, what's the difference? They kind of sound like the same thing.
Well, a word of wisdom is when the Holy Spirit lets us know just what to do in a situation. He may even show us what not to do sometimes. A word of wisdom can save us a lot of time and trouble. And a word of knowledge is when the Holy Spirit gives us some information that we wouldn't ordinarily know.
That one sounds like it'd be helpful for taking tests at school. Instead of studying, I could just ask for a word of knowledge so I'll know all the answers.
Well, that's not exactly what the gift is for. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians that all of the gifts of the Spirit are given to us not just for our benefit, but to help others. We can always pray and ask for help remembering what we've studied before we take a test, but I'm afraid you're still going to have to do your homework and study, Billy.
Oh, that's disappointing. Well, how many gifts of the Spirit are there, Miss April?
There are a total of 9 listed in 1 Corinthians 12. We're going to talk about some more of them if you want to stick around.
All right.
Great. Do you want to come out here?
No, thank you. I'm too shy. I'll just sit back here.
You don't really seem shy, but okay, Billy. Maybe next time you'll want to join us.
Maybe. I might come out there if I hear something about snack time.
Okay. Bye, Billy.
Bye, Miss April.